गुड आफ्टरनून. वी विल बी स्टडिंग चैप्टर 3 प्रेडिकेट लॉजिक पार्ट 5. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल जस्ट बी सॉल्विंग द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ क्वांटिफिकेशनल डिडक्शन. बिफोर दैट वी विल हैव टू जस्ट रिकॉल ऑल द रूल्स विच वी हैव स्टडीड सो फार. दैट इज द 9 रूल्स ऑफ इन्फरेंस एंड 10 रूल्स बेस्ड ऑन द रूल्स ऑफ रिप्लेसमेंट. Let us just recollect all those rules. That is, among the 9 we have rule of modus ponens, then we have rule of modus tollens, then rule of hypothetical syllogism, then we have the rule of disjunctive syllogism, then the rule of constructive dilemma, then we have the rule of destructive dilemma, then we have the rule of conjunction, then we have the rule of simplification and the rule of addition. These are the 9 rules of inference. Besides this, we have more rules, that is rules based on the rules of replacement. They are De Morgan's law, then we have double negation, associative law, distributive law, then we have commutative law, then rule of transposition, rule of material implication, rule of material equivalence, rule of tautology, and rule of exportation. Besides these 19 rules, we have 4 more rules. That is the rule of universal instantiation, then the rule of existential instantiation, then the rule of universal generalization and the rule of existential generalization. Now, before actually solving the exercise, we'll have to note certain points. The first is, when the conclusion has an universal quantifier, then always use an arbitrarily selected individual y as the substitution instance while using ui rule. So in the conclusion, if you have an universal quantifier, then always use y as the substitution when you are applying the rule of ui. Second, when the premise or the conclusion has an individual constant and one has to apply the rule of ui, then always use the same individual constant as the substitution instance to maintain uniformity throughout, so that one can draw the conclusion by using the required 19 rules of inference. So you have to note this down, that if in the premise there is an individual constant, then while using the rule of UI, use the same constant. Or if it is in the conclusion also, you have to use the same constant. Then next point is, in the rule of EI, the same individual constant given in the premise cannot be used as a substitution instance. Suppose in the premise some constant is given to you, then you cannot use the same constant for EI rule, but while dropping the existential quantifier. But you can use for UI while dropping universal quantifier. Then lastly, the rule, when the both the rules EI and UI are to be used in the same exercise, then always use EI first and drop the existential quantifier first and then the universal quantifier. Now we'll learn how to construct formal proof of validity for the arguments having quantified propositions. The first one, the given expression is universal quantifier AX horseshoe BX. Second is universal quantifier BX horseshoe CX. Therefore, universal quantifier AX horseshoe CX. Now, since the conclusion has an universal quantifier, while dropping the universal quantifier from the premise line and using the rule of UI, always use an arbitrarily selected individual y as a substitution. So now we'll apply the rule of ui to the first premise and replace x by y. So you will get ay horseshoe by first ui, then second also you'll apply the rule of UI and you will get BY horseshoe CY. And for the now you want to get the conclusion. So that is you want to get A and C. So for the third and fourth premises, which rule can you apply? You can see that the consequent of the third and the antecedent of the fourth step is common. So you can apply the rule of HS and you will get the fifth step as AY horseshoe CY by HS rule and application to which statements 3 and 4. Then in the sixth step, what you have to do is you have to add the universal quantifier, because here the conclusion has an universal quantifier. So you have to apply the rule of UG, and you know that UG can be applied only when we have an arbitrarily selected individual Y, not a constant. That is why we used your Y as the substitution instance, because later on we had to use the rule of UG. So now we'll add the universal quantifier and you will get universal quantifier AX horseshoe CX for the fifth statement, the rule of UG. Now we come to the second. First premise, universal quantifier DX horseshoe curl EX. Second premise, EM, therefore existential quantifier DX. Here in the second premise, an individual constant is given. So while dropping the universal quantifier from the first premise and using the rule of UI, you will replace X by M, because M is given in the second premise. So to maintain the uniformity, you have to use M. Though we are free to use both a constant as well as arbitrarily selected Y. So now you will get the third step as DM horseshoe curl EM. For the first, you are applying the rule of UI. Then the fourth step, you will apply the rule of DN to second and you will get curl curl EM. And then fifth step, you will get, which rule can you apply for 3 and 4? MT, because we have the negation of the consequent with us. So you will get negation of the antecedent. That is, we can get the negation of the antecedent only by one rule. That is the rule of MT. 3 and 4, you can see that the consequent is curl EM and its negation is double curl EM. So you will get the negation of the antecedent, that is DM's negation. So you will get curl DM. Now in the sixth step, that will be your fifth step. And now you will get in sixth step, you have to just add the existential quantifier. That is, there is only one rule by which you can add the existential quantifier. That is the rule of EG. And replace M by X. So you will get the expression as, in the sixth step, as existential quantifier curl dx by 5 eg. Now we come to the third. Given exercises, universal quantifier fx horseshoe gx, second existential quantifier fx dot hx, therefore existential quantifier gx dot hx. Now you can see that in the second premise there is an existential quantifier. So according to the rule, when UI and EI are to be used in the same exercise, we have always to use EI first and drop the existential quantifier. And according to the rule of EI, we have to always use a constant as a substitution which is not occurred in the premise line. So now we are free here because there is no constant in the premise. So we use your A as the substitution. So second premise, we are dropping the existential quantifier and replacing X by A. So in the third step, we get FA dot HA by the rule of EI, second. Then fourth, we have to drop the UI. You have to drop the universal quantifier and use the rule of UI. So for the first premise, and you will get FA horseshoe GA. We have to replace X by A because A is there in the third step. Now we have to get GA. GA is the consequent of the fourth premise. And to derive the consequent, there is only one rule, that is the rule of MP. But according to the rule of MP, we should have the antecedent with us. Where is the what is the antecedent of the fourth premise? It is FA. Where does it lie? In the third premise. But it is not separate. It is with HA. To separate FA or any conjunct, there is only one rule, that is the rule of simplification. So apply the rule of simplification for the third step and you will get the fifth step as FA. Then once you get FA, then you can apply the rule of MP to 4 and 5 and you will get GA in the sixth step. Once you get GA, now what you have to do? We need HA. HA is in the third premise, but it is on the right hand side. So as per the rule of simplification, only if it is the left conjunct you can simplify it. So it's on the right, so you have to bring it to the left. That is the only rule which by which you can bring, is the rule of commutation. So bring HA on the left and FA on the right, interchange the conjuncts by the rule of commutation, and once you get HA dot FA, then in the eighth step you can do is HA, you can simplify. And once you get HA, you can join GA with HA, 6 and 8, that is the which is the rule by which you can join the two propositions. There is only one rule, and that is the rule of conjunction. Then in the 10th step, you have to add the existential quantifier to it. There is only one rule by which you can add the quantifier, existential quantifier, and that is the rule of EG. So when you are adding the existential quantifier, A has to be replaced by X. So in the 10th step, you get existential quantifier GX dot HX by 9th EG. Now we come to the 4th. Universal quantifier GX horseshoe KX, existential quantifier LX dot curl KX, then third premise TF, therefore existential quantifier curl JX. Now here you must always remember that when EI and UI are to be used in the same exercise, always use EI. In EI we have to always substitute it by a individual constant and not that constant which occurs in the premise. And in the third premise there is F as a individual constant, so you have not to use that constant. Other than that you have to use. So to the second, I will apply the rule of EI and replace X by A. LA dot curl KA. This is my fourth step. Then fifth step, what you will do? You will apply the rule of UI to the first premise and you will get the fifth step, that is GA horseshoe KA. Then after getting that, what do you want? We want JA. How will you get JA? Negation of the antecedent in the fifth premise you can get only if you have the negation of the consequent by the rule of MT. There is only one rule by which we can get the negation of the antecedent, that is MT rule, and as per the rule we should have the negation of the consequent. Where is the negation of the consequent? In the fourth premise. Where is it? On the right hand side. So can we simplify it? No. What have we to do? You have to bring it on the left. Which is the rule by which you can bring it to the left? By the rule of commutation. So you apply the rule of commutation to the fourth step and you will get the sixth step, that is curl K dot LA. Curl KA dot LA, fourth commutation. Once you get the sixth step, now you can simplify. In the seventh step, you will get curl A KA, that is sixth simplification. Once you get the negation of the consequent, you will get the negation of the antecedent by applying the rule of MT to fifth and seventh, to get the step 8th, and you will get curl JA by the rule of MT. Then just you have to add the existential quantifier to the 8th step by the rule of EG. There is only one rule by which you can add the existential quantifier. So you added and replace A by X. So you will get in the 9th step existential quantifier curl JX. 8th is EG. This is the justification. Now we come to the 5th. Universal quantifier MX horseshoe NX, second premise universal quantifier nx horseshoe ox, third universal quantifier ox horseshoe px, therefore universal quantifier mx horseshoe px. Here all are universal quantifiers, but in the conclusion also there is an universal quantifier. So later on you have to use the rule of UG to add the quantifier. First you will drop and later on add. So according to the rule of UG, you cannot use the rule of UG to an individual constant. Only if it is an arbitrarily selected Y, then you can use. So while dropping the universal quantifier in the premise, you have, and using the rule of UI, you have to always use an arbitrarily selected individual Y in this case. So first step, first premise, you drop universal quantifier and you will get the fourth step MY horseshoe NY. Second step, you second premise you drop and you will get the fifth step NY horseshoe OY. Third premise you drop and you will get sixth step OY horseshoe PY. Then seventh, you can, which rule can you apply for 4 and 5? You can see that the consequent of the fourth is same as the antecedent of the fifth. So HS rule can be applied and you get MY horseshoe OY in the seventh step. And once you get in the seventh step MY horseshoe OY, you can see that 6 and 7 also OY is common, and you will get in the eighth step MY horseshoe PY by the same rule HS. And then you can add the universal quantifier to it. And in the ninth step, you will get universal quantifier MX horseshoe PX by the rule of UG. For the 8th step, you will apply that rule. So in the justification, you have to write 8th UG. Now we come to the 6th. The first premise is universal quantifier QX horseshoe RX. Second premise, existential quantifier SX dot curl RX. Therefore, existential quantifier SX dot curl QX. Now you can see that in the second premise there is an existential quantifier and in the first premise there is an universal quantifier. So we have always to apply the rule of EI and drop the existential quantifier first. But while dropping the existential quantifier and using the rule of EI, we have to always replace it by a constant. But the constant should not be the same that has occurred in the premise, and there is no constant in the premise line, so we are free to use any constant here. So we will use the rule of EI and drop the existential quantifier from the second premise and replace X by A. So the third step, we will get SA dot curl RA, second EI. Then in the fourth step, what we are going to do is we are going to drop the universal quantifier by UI rule and replace X by the same constant to maintain the uniformity throughout the exercise. So we get QA horseshoe RA while after dropping universal quantifier by the rule of UI. Then since now the third premise we have SA and we want SA in the conclusion, so it's a conjunctive proposition and the left conjunct you can infer by the only rule by which you can infer the left conjunct is the rule of simplification. So to the third step we will apply the rule of simplification and we'll get SA in the fifth step. After getting SA, we want curl QA. Where is QA in the fourth step? It is the antecedent, and to get the negation of the antecedent, we must have the negation of the consequent. What is the consequent RA? So RA, its negation is in the third premise and it is on the right hand side. So we can't separate it until and unless we bring it on the left. There is only one rule by which you can bring curl RA on the left and SA you can take it to the right, that is the rule of commutation, commutative law. So to the third step you are applying the rule of commutation and you will get curl RA dot SA. This is commutation, and after this step we want curl RA. So now here you can simplify curl RA from 6 step and you will get the 7 step as curl RA. 6 simplification. Now once you get the negation of the consequent, you can get the negation of the antecedent by empty rule. So 4th and 7th, you can apply the rule of empty, that is modus tollens. And 8th step, you will get curl QA. 4 and 7, empty. Once you get curl QA, now what you have to do? You have to join them, because in the conclusion, they are joined by a conjunction. So there is only one rule by which you can join both the propositions, that is the rule of conjunction. So 5th and 8th, we will join. In 9th step, you will get SA dot curl QA. 5 and 8, conjunction. Now, in the conclusion, you have an existential quantifier, so you have to add the existential quantifier to this 9 step by the rule of EG, and you will get the 10 step as existential quantifier SX dot curl QX. 9 step, you are applying the rule of EG. So now we'll start 7th. First is universal quantifier TX horseshoe UX. Second, existential quantifier TX dot WX. Third, ZA. Therefore, existential quantifier UX dot WX. Now, we can see in the second premise, there is an existential quantifier, and according to the rule, we can drop the existential quantifier first, then the universal quantifier. Now, since there is A in the third premise, we cannot use the same constant while dropping the existential quantifier and using the EI rule. We have to use other than A. So, for the second premise, we are using the rule of EI, and we get the fourth step TB dot WB. We will replace X by B. Now, for the first premise, we are using the rule of UI, and you will get the fifth step TB horseshoe UB. Here also you will replace X by B to maintain the uniformity. Now the sixth step, you will get TB by simplifying the fourth from the fourth statement TB. You know that we can separate TB from WB by the rule of simplification. Once we get TB, we can apply the rule of MP to fifth and sixth, and you will get in the 7th step UB. Once you get UB, now you want WB. WB is in the 4th premise, 4th step. So what will you do? You cannot simplify it until and unless you bring it on the left. So to interchange the conjuncts, we have to use the rule of commutation. There is only one rule by which you can interchange the conjuncts. So in the 8th step, we will get WB dot TB. For the fourth statement, you have used the commutative law. Now you can simplify it. In 9th step, you will get WB, that is 8th simplification. Then you have to join the U and W. So U is in 7th and W is in 9th. You join them. There is only one rule by which you can join, that is the rule of conjunction. So it will be UB dot WB. 7th and 9th conjunction. And 11th will be existential quantifier UX dot WX. We are adding an existential quantifier because it is in the conclusion existential quantifier. So 10th step, you are applying the rule of EG to get the 11th step. Come to the 8th. Universal quantifier AX horseshoe BX wedge DX. Second, universal quantifier AX. Third, existential quantifier curl BX, therefore existential quantifier DX. Now you can see that you have to use both UI and EI, so always use EI first and use individual constant as the substitution instant which has not occurred in the premise. There is no constant in the premise, so you are free to use any constant here in this exercise. So fourth is curl BA, you will get, you replace X by A and drop the existential quantifier from the third premise. Then you, in the fourth step, you get curl BA. Then you drop the universal quantifiers one by one. First premise you drop and you will get the fifth step AX horseshoe BA wedge DA. Then second premise you drop and you will get in the sixth step A. Now you can directly use the rule of MP for 5th and 6th, you can see the antecedents are same, so you can derive the consequence. So 7th step you will get BA wedge DA. Once you get BA wedge DA, we want DA. To get DA, which rule can you apply? Second disjunct. If you want to infer, then you should have the negation of the first disjunct by the rule of DS. So what is the first disjunct BA? Its negation is in the 4th step. So you can easily use the rule of DS and you will get in the 8th step DA. Once you get DA by the rule of DS, then you just add existential quantifier to it and replace A by X by the rule of EG. So 9th step is existential quantifier DX. 8th, you are applying the rule of EG. Now we come to the 9th. Universal quantifier EX, horseshoe HX, second universal quantifier EX, therefore universal quantifier GX, horseshoe HX. Now you have to remember that when the conclusion has an universal quantifier, what you have to do is later on you have to drop, after dropping you have to later on add the quantifiers. So UG rule has to be used, and in the rule of UG, we cannot apply the rule of UG if we have a constant, only if it is arbitrarily selected individual, then only you can apply the rule. So while dropping the UI, applying the rule of UI and dropping the universal quantifier, replace it by Y if you have in the conclusion an universal quantifier. So now in the first premise, you will drop the universal quantifier and you will get the third step, replace X by Y, EY horseshoe HY. Then second premise also, you drop the universal quantifier by UI rule and you will replace X by Y. So fourth step you will get EY. Now you can directly use the rule of MP and get the consequent HY in the fifth step. Once you get HY, then we want GY. We have to add G to it. But you remember that GX is on the left hand side and it is having a connective horseshoe. So when you are adding, you should always add curl G, so that when it is converted into horseshoe, then its sign changes. So in the sixth step, you will get HY wedge curl GY. Addition rule, you know, the missing proposition, as per the rule of addition, you can add anything to a given statement by the connective wedge. Then seventh, you just commute it and bring GY to the left side and HY to the right. In the seventh step, you get curl GY wedge HY. Then eighth step, what you have to do, change the wedge disjunctive statement, transform into implicative statement. When we are changing wedge into horseshoe, then what happens? The sign of the left component changes. So you will get GY horseshoe HY. Seventh, material implication. And ninth, you have just to add the universal quantifier by the rule of UG, that you will get universal quantifier GX horseshoe HX. Y is replaced by X. Now we come to the 10th, universal quantifier RX horseshoe SX, second universal quantifier TX horseshoe WX, third universal quantifier RX, fourth universal quantifier curl WX. Therefore, SE dot curl TE. Now see here, in the conclusion we have a constant. So while using the rule of UI and dropping the universal quantifier, replace X by the same constant. So one by one you will drop. First premise you will drop and you will get the fifth step RE horseshoe SE. Second premise you will drop and you will get the sixth step TE horseshoe WE by UI rule. Third premise you will drop the universal quantifier and you will get the seventh step RE. Then fourth step you will drop the universal quantifier by UI rule and you will get curl WE. After dropping all the universal quantifiers, now you can use the required 19 rules. That is, what do you want? SE. Where is SE? SE is in the fifth step. It is the consequent. To derive the consequent, we should have with us the antecedent, and there is only one rule by which you can derive the consequent, and that is the rule of MP. So to fifth and seventh, you can apply the rule of MP and you will get the consequent SE. Once you get the 9 step SE, then what do you want? Curl TE. Where does TE lie? In the 6th step. And it is the antecedent. We want the negation of the antecedent. So there is only one rule by which you can apply. That is empty rule. But to apply that rule, you should have the negation of the consequent. What is the consequent WE? Where is its negation? In the 8th step. So you can apply the rule of empty to 6 and 8 and you will get curl TE. Once you get curl TE, now what you have to do? Join them. There is only one rule by which you can join the two prepositions, and that is the rule of conjunction. That is the 9th and 10th. You are applying the rule of conjunction. Now we come to the 11th one, universal quantifier DX Hoshue EX. Second, universal quantifier GX Hoshue HX. Third, existential quantifier DX dot GX. Therefore, existential quantifier EX dot HX. Here you can see that existential quantifier has to be dropped first before universal quantifier, that we already know. And so we will drop the existential quantifier and we are free to use a constant here, any constant, because there is no constant given in the premise. So now replace X by A and drop the existential quantifier and you get the fourth step DA dot GA. For the third, you are applying the rule of EI. Then fifth step, you will get DA Hoshue EA, applying the rule of UI to the first step. And then sixth step, you get GA Hoshue HA. We are applying the rule of UI to the second step. And then now we want E. It is in the fifth premise. It is the consequent. To derive the consequent, we should have the antecedent with us. Antecedent is DA. It lies in the fourth premise. So you have to simplify it, separate it. There is only one rule, that is the rule of simplification. Fourth and seventh. Seventh step you get by applying the rule of simplification to four. Then apply the rule of MP to 5th and 7th and you will get EA. The consequent will be inferred. Once you get EA, we want HA. HA lies in the 6th step. It is the consequent again. So you should have with us, we should have GA with us. It is in the 4th premise. It is on the right. We can't simplify it because it should be in the left. Then only you can simplify it. So what you have to do, you have to apply the rule of commutation to interchange the conjuncts. Now once you interchange the conjuncts in the 9th step by the rule of commutation, then you can simplify in the 10th step GA. Once you get GA, then you can apply the rule of MP to 6th and 10th and you will get HA. Once you get HA, then you can join EA with HA. There is only one rule, that is the rule of conjunction. Once you join that, then you have to add existential quantifier to the statement, and that is by the rule of EG. And you will get and replace A by X. So existential quantifier EX dot HX 12th EG. Now we come to the 12th, last one, universal quantifier HX Hoshue KX. Second, existential quantifier HX dot curl LX. Third, LG. Therefore, existential quantifier KX. Now you can see that there is a constant given in the premise line. So when you are dropping the existential quantifier and using the rule of EI, you cannot use the same constant other than G you can use. So in the second premise, you are going to apply the rule of EI. Always you are applying the rule of EI first, then UI. So you replace X by A. So in the fourth step, you will get HA dot curl LA. Second premise, you have applied the rule of EI. Now you can separate HA and you will get the rule, by the rule of simplification, you will get the fifth step, you have to get HA Hoshue KA by the rule of UI, and then sixth step, you can apply the rule of simplification to the fourth step and you will get HA. Then you can apply the rule of MP to 5 and 6 and you will get KA. Once you get Ka, you have to add the existential quantifier by the rule of Eg, and you will get existential quantifier Kx. A you have to replace by x. For the seventh step, you are using the rule of Eg. So you need lot of practice for logic, and you have to give time and efforts to score good marks in logic. Thank you.